When Peter Falk announced to his father that he was going to be an actor, his father said, are you going to put all that paint on your face and make a silly ass out of yourself for the rest of your life?
That's right.
You put the paint on your face. But about that, you're taking notes here during this?
No, I was going to draw a little cartoon figure.
Cartoon figure of what?
Oh, I don't know anything. I don't know why I started to do that.
You're making a silly ass out of yourself in drawing. I think you better stick to acting.
Yes.
three Emmy Awards for Columbo. Incidentally, we're carrying Columbo here on 10-11 Strong on Tuesday nights. Peter, I would think the epitome that an actor could reach is to get a role that is so identified with you, there ain't nobody else who could ever do the role. I'm thinking of Yul Brynner in The King and I. That's his role. Columbo is your role. Now the trap is to be condemned permanently to play that role. Can we see you in any other role other than Columbo?
Well, so far it's worked out. I mean, the pictures that I've done since Columbo, the people liked it. They, you know, the in-laws, they like the in-laws. The screenings of this picture, they like that. Chief Detective, Murdered by Death. I don't see a problem there. I really don't see a problem.
I always see you as Columbo. It's so perfect. But I think you have the talent to
get. As a matter of fact, I want to do more Columbos.
That's what I was going to find out. All that are done are in the can now.
Oh, yeah, we haven't made a new one in about 4 years. Been a long time since we made it.
Can you do some more? Will you do some more?
Well, I think there's a good chance. Yes, I do.
Now, you directed one of them, didn't you?
Yeah.
Was that shot right here?
Yeah.
Century City?
The one that I directed, right. I was thinking of another one.
About
because I partially directed another one. But the one with the architect was right here in Century City. As a matter of fact, right around the corner here. Mm-hmm. One of these buildings hadn't been built yet. And at that time, it was a big excavation site, and we shot it there, right.
All right, now how could you handle both acting and directing, and did you feel like you'd handled it?
I thought I handled, you know, it was a strange thing that happened there, Leta, with that. A lot of the things that you worry about as an actor, I didn't worry about on that show, and I learned something from it. I learned that a lot of the things that I'm worried about are really unnecessary. They're all in my head. Because as a director, what I was doing, I was thinking about this, I was thinking about that, the camera, the lights, the other actors, the scene, the words, the other thing. And I would just run in. I'd just run in and start talking. And I realized that's a lot better way to do it. And not to get all worked up ahead of time. And there was something about the spontaneity of not even thinking about the acting that I found helpful.
Does your eye ever bother you in terms of the lights and the camera angles?
No, not at all.
He lost his eye when he was 3 due to a tumor, right? But I've understood that you've been able to do it with humor. There was an incident where you were playing baseball in high school,
right.
And you slid into second base.
Third base.
Oh, slid into third base. And what happened?
Base. Well, the guy called me out, and I took out the eye, and I handed it to the umpire.
He could see a lot better with your eye. How long? What? What were you going to say?
I was thinking that there was a time, well, it's too long a story, but at any rate, when I was going to college, in those days, you used to have glass eyes. Now you have plastic. When you have glass eyes, sometimes they you get a little bit too much suppuration if it's in the hot weather. So you take the eye out in order to give the socket a rest, blah, blah, blah. But at any rate, my friends there at college, they stole it. I took the thing, and I didn't have any eye, and I was walking around no eye, and then I put over here my hand like this here, and I had a handkerchief over it, and I said, hey, come on, let's go into town, and we're going to hear Earl Gardner. He was playing jazz piano. We went down there, and we said, come on, get up around the piano, and when I got up around the piano, he had a little jigger of gin, and at one point, I looked down, and I'll be a son of a gun, there was my eye. They put it right in the jig of the gin. The alcohol wiped away all the veins. It didn't have any veins in it.
The reason we are here with Mr. Falk, in addition to Columbo on 10-11 Strong, is he has a new movie called All the Marbles. It's all about wrestling. Do you know anything about wrestling?
Not much, no.
You can count them out there on the map. One,
right,
two, three.
Right.
Who's going to see this film, Peter? Who do you think, to whom will it appeal?
Well, I think this film, everybody's going to see the film. It's the same thing like Rocky. The people who went to see Rocky, millions went, you know, and enjoyed Rocky. They did, not because they were boxing fans, that isn't the reason they went. They went because they found a character there that they could root for, that they cared about, and they pulled off a miracle. They found a guy that in the beginning was a stumble bum, he was collecting bad debts, he'd never be heavyweight champion of the world, and they saw him go through a series of experiences, and they saw him train and sweat and get beat up, and then they wanted him to win. And this is the same thing here. There's nothing to do. Yeah, there's nothing to do with whether it could be boxing, it could be any damn thing. People just want to go to a movie and they want to be able to laugh and root and care and cheer. I saw this picture in Times Square in New York. They almost tore off the roof when the girls came in. And you know, you saw the picture?
Oh, yeah.
When they come into Las Vegas and they got those costumes
those magnificent
on.
Magnificent costumes.
They go wild. When they beat up the referee, they just go wild.
Let's see if I can do it the way you do it. One last question. Is that the way you do it? What's the name of the movie?
All the Marbles.
It certainly is. And he's got them all. Peter Falk, it's been a pleasure, an honor. Thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure for me.
Peter Falk, All the Marbles. We'll be right back in the morning show right after this word.